有一位韦斯敏斯特的神学家这么说。
Westminster theologian once said.
先解一下韦斯敏斯特的神学家。
First, want to explain theologian from Westminster.
刚才我说，教会曾经有一个大公会议，是为订立了韦斯敏斯特信条。
And earlier on, I said that there is a great council that determined the Westminster Creed.
我刚才我讲错了，一位同工指证说，是100多位的当时的主教这个可以说是神学家。
And we can say that it's 100 over these theologians.
他们集中5.5年的时间。
And they gathered for 5.5 years.
结果定下了韦斯敏斯特的信条。
And as determined this Westminster this creed.
所以那些神学家参加那一次的大公会议的，就称为韦斯敏斯特这个神学家。
And those people who attended the council then were called the theologians from the Westminster.
他讲神的话绝对是。
And so the word of God is absolutely yes.
教义跟崇拜。
And in terms of doctrine and worship,
信仰跟生活的唯一的、最有权威的、无错误的准则。
And it's an infallible, inerrant, absolute authority of this faith and conduct.
所以以赛亚先知就讲了这句话了。
And therefore, Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah said,
以赛亚书第8:20.
Book of Isaiah chapter 8 verse 20.
人当以训诲和法度为标准，他所说若不与此相符，必不得见晨光。训诲和法度在旧约的时候都是指着这个神的话，旧约是圣经。
The law and the testimony refers to the word of God in the Old Testament.
所以这里说人当以圣经为标准。
Man ought to take the Old Testament as a standard.
他讲的当然是当时的旧约。
And that's talking about the Old Testament.
旧约的权威老早已经确定了。
And the authority of the Old Testament long ago been determined.
怎么确定的？
How do you affirm it?
耶稣说，我做见证的就是这经。
And the scriptures testify about me.
所以刚才我们已经从圣经看到了。
And from the Bible you can see.
保罗说是神所默示的。
And Paul said that it is inspired by God.
所以旧约圣经是如此。
And for the Old Testament, it is so.
当新约圣经成为正典的时候
，And when the New Testament Bible became the canon,
它也是如此。
It is indeed so.
人当以，如果我们今天要利用使用这句话呢
？If we apply this word today,
人当以新旧约圣经为标准。
Man ought to take the Old and New Testaments as their standard.
他所说的
，And what they say,
若不与此相符
，If we do not speak accordingly,
如果我们所讲的道。教会的无论的信仰的课题或者这个信仰的实践，如果没有跟圣经相符的话
，If the word and the practice of the church is not according to our faith，
必不得见晨光。
You shall have no light of the dawn。
我们就看见圣经的权威性。
And we see the authority of the Bible。
刚才有一句话，不晓得大家记得吗？
I do not know whether you remember this word.
我们说使徒时代过去了。
We say that the age of the apostles are over.
使徒的权威也过去了。
The authority of the apostles are gone.
所以一个新的权威是必须的。
And a new is necessary for a new authority.
所以圣经就成为这个新的权威。
The Bible is this new authority.
所以今天圣经是生活跟信仰的最高准则。
Therefore, the Bible is a faith, the standard for our faith and conduct.
那么，当我们在论到这个教皇说教皇是人教皇的权威。
When we talk about the authority of the Pope,
我们说教皇是超越教皇是超越圣经的了。
And therefore we say the Pope surpasses the Bible.
他可以增加增加这个比方说新旧约是他们接受新旧约是神的启示是神的话，不过他们可以增加了一些教会的议案。教会讨论的议案，教皇的这个谕令，教皇的命令。
And so they can accept that the Bible is authority, but they also can accept includes the decree of the church and the decree of the Pope as well.
所以基督教会一般是拒绝这样的一个权威，
and
教皇的权威。
And so the church basically rejected the authority of the Pope.
他们就反驳说，你们虽然没有教皇的权威，但是你们有一个纸上的权威。
So they rebutted saying that although you do not have the authority of the Pope, but you have a paper Pope.
这个里面有个纸上的教皇。
You have the paper pope.
它指的是什么呢
？And what do they refer to？
因为我们把圣经啊，新旧约圣经正典呢，当作这个权威，是唯一跟信仰跟生活的权威准则。
Because we take the Old and New Testaments as an absolute standard of our faith and conduct.
你怎么看
？And what is your view？
你能够接受这样的说法吗
？Can you accept this？
我想，这是不一样的。
I believe this is different.
首先，圣经的权威是。就已经局限在圣经里面了。
That the authority of the Bible lies within the Bible.
我们也看见，从刚才看见，耶稣亲自肯定了旧约的权威。
And we see that Jesus himself had testified the authority of the Old Testament.
我们也看见旧约的新约的权威是经过了300多年才确立的。
That the authority of the New Testament has been affirmed after 300 years.
首先，作者是使徒。
First of all, the author must be an apostle,
or
closely related to the apostles.
其次是当时的众教会，虽然当时有几百卷，不过这二十几卷是当时的众教会所用的。
Although there are hundreds of articles and documents, but these 27 have been used by the churches widely.
在三百多年的大公会议上
，in the council of the AD 300,
那么就被肯定
，and it has been affirmed.
所以实用性。
The usage,
时间，这个作者
，and the authors,
还有这个时间持久性
，and the continuity in time,
到今天已经2000年了
，up to now 2000 years,
还有会议大公会议的这一个肯定
，and it has been affirmed determined by the councils,
所以新约的权威也就这样确立
，and therefore the affirmation for the New Testament,
所以当教会离开了新旧约的这个启示之后呢
？Therefore, if the church were to depart from the revelation of the Old and New Testaments,
那么他就需要改变了。
Therefore, they need to change.
需要把教会带回圣经。
They need to bring the church back to the Bible.、
这个是宗教改革。
This is a reformation.、
所以它跟社会的其他的都没有什么关系。
Nothing to do with all the things happening in the society.
它是发生在教会内的一件很重要的事情。
Yeah, major incident that happened within the church.
当然，它可以因为这样而影响到整个世界。
Because of this, could influence the whole world.
但它的的确确是一个回归圣经的运动。
But it is a movement that brings us back to the Bible.
它也是一个宏观的护教。
It is also a macro view of apologetics.
其实宗教改革就是护教。
And the Reformation is an apologetics.
第四纪教会因为新约圣经尚未完全。
During the first century, the New Testament had not been completed.
然而教会仍然有纯正的教导。
But the church still had very sound teaching.
虽然新约圣经还没有出现。
Although the New Testament Bible had yet to appear.
只有一些书卷。
You have any books and letters.
可是教会仍然有纯正的教导。
But the church still had very sound teaching.
这些纯正的教导。
And all this sound teaching.
圣经本身自己说。
And the Bible itself says.
我们翻加拉太书一章11-12节。
We turn to the book of Galatians, chapter 1, verses 11 to 12.
弟兄们，我告诉你们，我素来所传的福音不是出于人的意识。
I want you to know, brothers, that the gospel I preach is not something that man made up.
因为我不是从人领受的，也不是人教导我的。
I did not receive it from any man, nor was I taught it.
乃是从耶稣基督启示来的。
But rather, I received it by the revelation from Jesus Christ.
所以第四纪的教会是人的教导。
And in the first century, the church received instruction from man.
但绝对不是人的教导。
But it is also not the instruction of man.
明白吗？
Do you know this?
是人的口在教导。
Instructed from the mouth of man.
不是从人领受的。
But it's not of man.
不是出于人的意识。
Not from the will of man.
而是从耶稣基督的启示来的。
But by the revelation of the Lord Jesus Christ.
加拉太书一章七节。
Galatians 1:7.
有些人要把基督的福音更改了。
And there were some who want to change, alter the gospel of Jesus.
我们就发现第四纪的教会开始有偏离圣经的这样的情况发生了。
So in the church of the first century, we see people who want to pervert the truth.
所以这个是我们讲到看到当时的情况。
So we see
有人要把基督的福音更改了。
There were some who want to pervert the gospel of Jesus.
所以你后来看到整个教会离开圣经。 其实也是有已经使徒时代的教会已经有先例了。
And so when we see churches departing from the Bible, we see examples in the apostolic church.
到了这个提摩太后书一章十三节
，Second Timothy chapter one verse 13。
使徒保罗对他的青年同工提摩太这么说
，And the apostle Paul told his young co-worker Timothy。
我们看提摩太后书一章十三节
，Second Timothy chapter one verse 13。
你从我听的那纯正话语的规模，要用在耶稣基督里的信心和爱心，常常守拙。你从我听的那纯正话语的规模
，When what you heard from me, the pattern of sound teaching。
所以当时虽然是使徒们在讲道
，Although the apostles were preaching，
但都是纯正的。
But they are all sound teaching，
这是可以肯定。
And this is sure。
提摩太后书二章十八节
，Second Timothy 2:18。
我们用这么多的圣经
，We use so many verses，
其实就要让大家知道
，That we may know
第一代的教会
，That the
第四纪的教会
，The churches of the first century
已经所传的就是纯正的道理。
And what they were sharing is sound preaching。
提摩太二后书二章十八节，保罗说：“他们偏离了真道，说复活的事已过，就败坏好些人的信心。”
And Paul said that these people who have wandered away from the true one, they say that resurrection has already taken place, and they destroy the faith of some.
我们看见什么
？And what do we see？
其实也有一方面有纯正的道，一方面也有一个势力，有一个运动，有一个势力要把。这个把人带离开真道。
On the one hand, we have sound teaching. On the other hand, there is another movement or a force want to bring people away from the truth.
所以到今天，当我们说今天宗教改革的第五百年的今天
，And today, after 500 years of Reformation,
我们说很多教会也渐渐的偏离真道。
We see many churches have deviated from the truth.
有些人啊不同意。
There are some who disagree.
他们说这不过是今天今天的时代不同了，所以我们要改变。
He said, "No, today's the times are different. We need to change."
所以我们真的是要当心。
We must be careful.
第一世纪
，the first century
有纯正的道
，we have a sound teaching，
也有一个势力要把人带离开真道。
There is a force who want to lead people away from the truth.
这些纯正的大教导是使徒等人。使徒们直接领受基督的启示。
And all these sound pattern of teaching are the direct revelation received by the apostles.
虽然如此
，though it was so，
第四纪的教会也常常受异端邪说的威胁。
And the churches of the first century often come under the threats of heresy and wrong teachings，
使教会面临沦为异端。异教的危险
，so much so that the church faces a danger of reducing into a heretic and another religion。
这些危险呢，好像加拉太书五章二到四节
，and such threats just like in Galatians chapter 5 verse 2-4。
我们要看到这些事实
，we want to see these realities。
五章二到四节。
chapter 5 verse 2-4。
我保罗告诉你们，若受割礼，基督就与你们无异了。
Mark my words, I, Paul, tell you that if you let yourselves be circumcised, Christ will be of no value to you at all.
我在指着凡受割礼的人确实地说，他是欠着行全律法的债。
Again, I declare to every man who lets himself be circumcised that he is obligated to obey the whole law.
你们这要靠律法称义的，是以基督隔绝，从恩典中坠落了。
And you who are trying to be justified by law have been alienated from Christ and fallen from grace.
如果我们今天来说呢？
If you were to say today,
没有关系，大家领受不一样吗
？It's all right. Everybody receive the same.
他喜欢割礼，就让他再割礼一次吧。
If you want to be circumcised, so be it.
他最低限度还有卫生的作用。
At least as a hygiene purpose.
不要紧。
It's all right.
今天我们是不是常常会听到这样的论调
？Do we often hear such sounds?
可是保罗怎么说
？But what did Paul say?
保罗非常坚定地说
，Paul said so determinedly.
你们要靠律法称义。
If you want to be justified by the law,
基督隔绝。
You are alienated from Christ.
从恩典中坠落了。
And fall from grace.
你们要这么做
Do you want to do so?
你们肯定不得救的
Surely you will not be saved.
如果不是保罗讲的不是圣经讲的
If The Bible did not say, or Paul did not say this.
今天是由我们来讲。
If we were to say,
十个人九个半说我们太狭窄了。
And out of 10 people, 9.5 would say we are too bigoted or narrow.
你同意吗？
Wouldn't you agree?
今天我们也常常被人指着我们太狭窄了。
Many people accuse us that we are very narrow.
为什么这么强调圣经的绝对性？
Why emphasize on the absolute standard of the Bible?
各位，你就知道。宗教改革，今天我们仍然这个科目，今天变成是一个十分重要的一个科目。
Therefore, you realize that this lecture, this topic of Reformation is so important.
这样的一个做法有什么危险呢？
Such a way of doing, is there any danger?
使基督教沦为犹太教的危险。
There's a danger of reducing Christianity into Judaism.
到了提摩太前书四章一节，刚才我们。也读到了提摩太前书四章一节。
When you come to 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 1,
多翻点圣经。
Let's turn to the Bible.
圣灵明说，在后来的时候，必有人离弃真道，听从那引诱人的邪灵和鬼魔的道理。
The Spirit clearly says that in the latter times, some will abandon the faith and follow deceiving spirits and things taught by demons.
必离弃真道，就是离开真道，离开圣经。
Abandon the faith, abandon the Bible.
听从鬼魔邪灵的道理。
And follow the deceiving spirits and things taught by the
demons. 这样的一个情况威胁，让教会沦为异教。
And such a threat caused the church to be reduced to another religion.
今天很多的做法，很多教会里面有时候。我们也看见让教会沦落成为异教。
Many patterns and things done by the church seems that the church has become another religion.
有时候教会的一些见证。
And some testimonies of the church.
我们看见他们讲见证。
They share their testimonies.
那些见证真的是好像异教徒的见证一样。
Just as testimonies from other religions.
那么提摩太后书四章三节，再翻下去，提摩太后书四章三节。
Second Timothy chapter 4 verse 3.
因为时候要到，人的厌烦纯正的道理，耳朵发痒，就随从自己的情意，增添好些师父。
For the time will come when men will not put up with sound doctrine, instead to suit their own desires, will gather around them a great number of teachers.
并且掩耳不听真道，偏向荒谬的言语。
And so they do not, their itching ears do not want to hear this.
这种情况了，这种离开真道。可能带来了异端。
Such turning away from the truth may bring about this extreme.
沦为基督教，沦为犹太教，沦为异教，带来异端，都是这种离开圣经的威胁。
And all these are the threats and dangers that are departing from the Bible to be reduced to a heretic, to this extremist and another religion.
再看一处。
And one more.
约翰一书。
First letter of John.
我们看这个五章的十二节。
You look at chapter 5 verse 12.
人有了神的儿子就有生命，没有神的儿子就没有生命。
And he that has a son of has a son has life. He does not have the son of God does not have life.
这样为什么呢
？Why？
因为他带来了独一神论的异端。
It bring about the heresy or unitarianism.
为什么带来独一神论的异端
呢 ？Why bring about this heresy？
因为我们的神是三位一体的真神。
Because our God is a three in one God。
所以你把父跟子分开的时候呢
？If you were to dissect the Father from the Son，
那么这个就是独一，很可能就成为独一神论的异端。
You become the heresy of having only one God。
后来教会真的发生了独一神论的异端。
And so the church indeed later on bring about this heresy。
好，所以我们看见从第二世纪跟第五世纪的教会。
And so from the church in the second to the fifth century, we move on。
这个叫做大公教会的时代。
There is a Catholic Church period。
教会面对偏离真道的威胁。
And so the church faced a threat of departing from the word.
有异端的福音。
You have this gospel of heresy.
就是犹太教派。
You're from Judaism.
有外邦的异端。
And the pagans are heresies.
复活是灵性的复活。
And the resurrection is only spiritual.
耶稣与基督是完全分开的。
That Jesus and Christ were separated.
当时已经出现这些异端。
And there are such heresies appearing.
还有呢
？And
基本上啊，已经是异教而非基督教了。
And it's another religion and not Christianity.
这是大公教会时代已经发生的了。
And this
is 发现的了。
All these have been discovered during the Catholic period.
那么，所以有三类的错误。
There are three kinds of error.
一类要把教会带回犹太教。
And one is to bring the church back into Judaism.
一类是把外邦的异端带进教会。
One is to bring the pagan heretics into the church.
第三是教会内部的错误。
And thirdly is the internal errors of the church.
教会内部的错误有一种叫做马基安或者马西昂主义。
And one of the errors is Marcionism.
这个马基安是他说创造神跟救赎神不是同一位。
This Marcionism says that the God the Creator and God the Redeemer were not one and the same.
创造神跟救赎神不是同一位。
That God the Creator, God the Redeemer are not the same.
刚才约翰一书那个地方已经为这些异端埋下了种子了。
And just now in first letter of John said, has sowed the seeds for such heresies.
他不，这个马其安，他不接受新约正典。
And Marcion did not accept the authority of the New Testament.
他另写新约。
He rewrote the New Testament.
所以我们因为有了正典，我们就知道他要另写新约，他就错了。
And having the canon, he want to rewrite this New Testament. He is wrong.
所以我们看今天有一些所谓教会。
We see there are some so-called churches.
他们有了圣经。
They have the Bible.
他们自己还有经典。
They have others.Scriptures.
最有名的是一个有的圣经，还有一本跟圣经同等权威的摩门经。
Of course, one of the more these infamous ones having the Bible, and beside they have another book of the same authority, Book of the Mormons.
我们从新约的权威就肯定他们是错误的。
And from the authority of the New Testament, we know they were wrong.
除了马基安，还有个孟他奴主义。
And besides the Marcionism, they had the Montanism.
这个孟他奴主义原本他的心地很好，他看见教会开始有堕落了，人一边信主一边犯罪。
Originally, Montanus saw is they had good intentions, so the church has wrong they sin.
所以他强调要严厉的、很严厉的生活。
So he this emphasized a very strict
生活要非常的圣洁的。
You must be very holy in your life.
他可是他重视预言。
But he leaned towards heavily towards these prophecies.
他重视预言。
He leaned towards prophecies.
然后呢，他也强调灵异。
He also emphasized spiritual phenomena.
灵异就是属灵恩赐了。
The spiritual gifts.
今天有人说属灵，好像今天有人说你如果圣灵充满，你才能够得救。
Just as some people say, if you are filled by the Spirit, then you can be saved.
所以，可是圣灵充满，你要有可以看得到的。
But when you are filled by the Spirit, it must be visible.
就是你能够说方言。
That you can speak in tongues.
就是你能够有这样那样的表现出来。
You have this or that kind of manifestation.
孟他奴。其实像今天如果有人这么说的话，他们不是开先例。孟他奴当时已经这样的观点了。
People say such things they are not pioneer, but Montanus at them said so.
而且他们继续领受启示。
And they continue to receive revelation.
他们所得的启示是超越新约圣经。
And the latter revelation they receive, they say, is higher than the Bible.
今天有没有教会继续领受启示呢？
Are there churches receiving revelation today?
有没有教会继续领受特殊启示呢？
Are they just still receiving special revelation today? No. Yes, indeed.
特殊启示经当时特殊启示是怎么样给我们的？
And how
给教会的？
How are the special revelation given to the churches then?
这些圣经的作者
and do the authors of the Bible?
他们有的看到异象了。
Some saw visions.
像这个使徒约翰
like the Apostle John.
他们有的听见声音了。
Some heard voices.
好像保罗听见声音。
Like Paul heard voices.
彼得也可以看见异象，也听见声音。
And Paul saw a vision and heard a voice.
有些做梦了。
Some dreamt.
所以有些与主相遇了。
And some met the Lord.
有些被提到天上去。
Some were caught up to heaven.
当时启示就是这样赐给人的。
And at that time, revelation was given to men in such ways.
当然更多是神上帝的灵在人心中做感动的工作，引导人写出启示。
More so that the Spirit of God moved people to write out revelation.
当圣经结束之后，当圣经新约圣经完成之后
，When the New Testament Bible had been completed,
这类特殊启示都停止了。
And all these special revelation come to a cessation.
今天我们会做梦吗
？Today will we dream?
会
，Yes,
但没有意义
，But meaningless.
今天我们会听见有好像人家对我们说话吗
？Today will you hear people talking to us?
有可能有
，Maybe.
不过那是头脑问题的。
Something wrong with the brain.
今天因为特殊启示已经停止了
because special revelation had ceased
所以这些梦
or the dreams.
还说看到异象
visions.
听到什么话语
hearing voices
都没有意义了
meaningless.
啊，可是他们说不是啊。
But they say no.
今天我的梦，我讲，我看我的梦，我看到的异象
my dreams, my visions.
我听到的声音
I heard.
跟圣经是同等权威的
had the same authority as the Bible
这些人这些教会可能就在我们的周围
these churches or people may be around us
而且不是一间两间很多都在我们的周围
maybe not one or two but many many around us
各位
Beloved,
这是现代的孟他奴主义
this is the Montanism nowadays
有时候我们把这派称为灵异派
sometimes we call it as a special supernatural group
以前称为灵恩派啦
Last time you called it the charismatic.
可是我们知道灵恩是好的字嘛？灵恩，我们一定要灵恩。
But we know charisma, this is a good word.
灵恩，灵恩，无宣接大灵恩，我们唱。
We always sing.
我们唱到这个灵恩还要充满我们的心。
It must fill our hearts.
灵恩，灵恩，啊，今天今日充满我心。
That you fill our hearts today.
啊，所以，可是当时呢？孟他奴主义后来被宣判为异端
But this Montanism had been declared a heresy
不过这是在几百年之后
But that's hundreds of years later
可见他在几百年当中 也影响或者危害许多的人
In the few hundred years he influenced and harmed many people
但是没有想到就在这末世他死灰复燃
But who knows in these latter times he had a revival
所以教会继续发展了
As the church continued to progress,
前面讲的大公教会面对偏离圣经的威胁是宏观方面的 大方面的
And so the Holy Catholic facing the danger of departing from the Bible is on a macro view.
可是我们现在讲的呢
But what we talk about now?
是主后三百年之后
After AD 300,
主后三百年之后教会离开圣经
After AD 300 when the church departed from the Bible,
那么是微属于微观方面的一点一点的离开圣经
and it's a micro departure from the Bible bit by bit
这张表
and this notes
主后三百年
AD 300
教会
the church、huh?
当时只有教会
at the time they only have this church
如果我们活在当时
if we were living at the time
我们也是这个教会如果我们一信主也是这个教会的成员
and we believe in the Lord we are members of this church
像当时就是大公教会
because the Holy Catholic Church
没有什么天主教基督教
you don't have Christianity
没有说什么东正教摩门教都没有
or the Mormonism or the Eastern Orthodox、
就是、大公教会
Catholic Church
大公教会你看大公教会是我们说是主耶稣用宝血所买来的。
And we say the Catholic Church has been redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus, but this church
一步一步的
step by step
主后三百年
AD 300,
他们开始为死人祷告了。
They started to have prayers for the dead.
今天仍然有些教会为死人祷告而不知道这是不对的。
And there are some churches who are still praying for the dead and not knowing they are wrong.
也是主后三百年。
And AD 300,
主后三百年
AD 300,
他们开始画十字做记号
And started to make the sign of the cross
主后375年
375,
他们开始崇拜圣徒跟天使
Started to worship the saints and angels
一步一步的
Step by step
崇拜圣徒跟天使就变成什么
And worshiping
他说不是不是我们不是把他当作神
and we are not taking them as
崇拜他向他祷告
pray to them as all
所以变成有耶稣以外还有中保了
in other words besides Jesus there are other mediators
主后394年
394
开始了弥撒之礼
having the ritual of mass
主后431年
431 AD
他那时还是大公教会
still the, this Catholic Church age
开始敬拜玛利亚
started to worship Mary
然后主后500年
AD 500
教士穿着与平信徒不一样教士的穿着与平信徒不一样
The priest dresses differently from the common believers
教士跟平信徒分开了
There's a separation between the clergy and the layman
啊就是教会有阶级了。
In other words, there are different levels in the church.
主后526年
526 AD
有临终末有礼出现了。
Have the, this sacrament of the extreme unction.
什么叫临终末有呢？
Why this extreme unction?
就是比方说，哦，一个人快要死了。
Somebody is about to die.
就拿一罐油替他抹油。
And take an oil and anoint him.
啊，即使没有油，用水也可以。
And no oil, water also can.
这是什么？
And
这后来被接受为教会七个圣礼当中的一个。
And later on, it is added, included as one of the seven sacraments of the church then.
而教会的圣礼，照着圣经的启示，只有什么？
But if you follow the Bible, how many sacraments are there?
只有两个礼。
Two.
旧约也是两个礼。
No, Old Testament, there were two.
旧约是割礼跟逾越节的礼。
No, Old Testament is a circumcision and Passover.
当旧约过去的这两个礼，割礼、逾越节的礼，是影子。实体来到就不再需要了。
And so the Passover and circumcision Old Testament were shadows when the reality comes.
耶稣本身就设立了两个礼。
And Jesus himself instituted two sacraments.
在他受难之前，他设立了这个圣餐之礼。
Before his passion, he instituted the Lord's Supper.
在他复活之后
，after his resurrection, he instituted
the Lord's外面做的门徒为他们施洗
，Go and make disciples of all nations and baptize them。
也就是两个礼，两个圣礼
，Only two sacraments。
但是后来就增加了七个圣礼。
But later on, they added five others to become seven sacraments。
这是离开圣经
，A departure from the Bible。
引进了，主后526年引进的这个炼狱的教义
，8526， including the doctrine of purgatory。
然后主后600年
8600
规定崇拜一定要用拉丁文
and determine that mass must be conducted in Latin
虽然今天他们可能今天可能改了
maybe they changed today
当时的确是这样
but at that time it was so
然后主后600年也是主后600年
8600
直接向玛利亚祷告
and can pray directly to Mary
主后607年
and 8607
有一位称为 Boniface应该翻译成邦尼费斯的教皇三世
，and so，
因为这位邦尼费斯的设立第一位教皇
，they set up the very first pope，
教皇叫邦尼费斯三世
，and Boniface the third，
主后607年
，and 607，
我们看见在整个，他不是一下子说教会变成离开圣经变成另外一个，好像不是教会的。
And it's not immediately at one go that it became depart from the Bible and became doesn't look at the church anymore.
它是渐渐的来离开圣经。
Gradually departure.
所以我们知道，当第一步踏上错误之路
，if the first step is wrong，
接下来第二步、第三步
，that which follows a second，
并且速度是越来越快
，and the speed。Gathers up.
所以基督教会就由大公教会时代发展情形就是这样。
And therefore, the Christian church from the Catholic church period, it develops until such a stage.
我们讲了两堂。
We have finished two periods.
讲三点。
Three points.
第一点。
Number one.
宗教，我们发现宗教改革其实是一个宏观的护教行动。
That the Reformation is a macro view of defending the faith.
是带把圣宗教改革是把圣把教会带回圣经，带回圣经之路。
And it is the movement to bring the church back into the Bible.
第二，我们说，既然回归圣经，圣经必然是有权威性的。
And secondly, since we return the Bible, therefore the Bible must have utmost authority.
所以我们第二堂就讲到这个圣经的这个第二章就讲到这个圣经权威性是怎么确立的。
Therefore, you talk about how the authority of the Bible came about.
这是刚才我们讲的。
We have said earlier.
现在我们讲。
And now we say,
从大公教会时代开始
，and from the beginning of the Catholic Church,
我们就看见教会是一步一步的。
We see gradually, step by step.
它不是立刻
，not immediately.
它经过了，比方说主后300年
，and for example 300,
从为死人祷告
，from starting from prayers for the dead,
到设立教皇
，under the first pope,
经过了多少？经过了600多年，三百多年。
It 300 years had passed.
所以如果每一点点一点点一点点
bit by bit
到了1500年的时候呢
when you come to 1500
就有太多的离开圣经的这一个做法了
and there are many ways that departed from the Bible
所以如果没有改革的话
If there were no reformation.
我在想如果早一点能够有出现这个改革。
If we can have reformation earlier.
那刚更好。
Isn't it better?
不可能早一点呢这些也不是很大的错误。
Maybe it may not be very grave errors.
哎呀我向玛利亚祷告不是我。她是耶稣的母亲，所以她是蒙大恩的女子。我们尊崇她了，不是、哎、不是不是拜她。
We are not worshiping her. She's a woman of great grace, mother of Jesus. We respect her.
啊，我们尊崇她，对对对，可以尊崇她。
We respect her.
啊，谢谢你，玛利亚。
Thank you, Mary.
啊，尊崇她嘛。
Respect her 啦。
这没有什么大错误。
No error 啊。
以致当马丁路德啊发现问题的时候，他也说。玛利亚来救我。
什么时候 when Martin Luther encountered difficulties, he cried out, Mary, save me.
所以我相信马丁路德后来反对的不是这个向玛利亚祷告。
So, Martin Luther did not object to pray to Mary.
主要的不是向玛利亚祷告。
It's not, the main thing is not against Mary.
教会一定发展到有一些事情呢使他们怎么样非改革不可了。
And the church has developed until a stage whereby
而在圣灵的帮助下
and under the guidance of the Spirit,
改革就开始了
and thus began Reformation.
我们还没有讲到宗教改革我们现在只是讲到宗教改革之前的一些教会的情形
We talk about the things that happened before the Reformation.
所以通知朋友
You can inform your friends.
通知教会一些的其他的信徒
and other believers in church.
他们可以来参加我们的周一周三的夜课
They can come to attend our Monday and Wednesday night lectures.
我们祷告